Hi, this is Fabio Amurri, and welcome to the third part of this walkthrough video series for the Synchron Woodwinds. In the first half of the video, we will navigate all the articulations available for the low and high woodwind ensembles, while in the second half, I'd like to show you a couple of ideas how to use these patches to create a more modern and textural sound using the built-in Synchron mixer and plugins. We start with the patch you just heard, the Woodwinds FX Low, consisting of 8 musicians playing in unison and octaves and offering a wide variety of articulations and possibilities. Here is the regular version of the articulations available. As you can see, we are presented with the same set of articulations the clusters variant offers. I can tell you that, in my opinion, it is great to have pre-recorded clusters, because for more than one reason you wouldn't achieve the same sound stacking regular notes together, and that's meant for any library out there. And my favorite thing is a feature that users of the Synchron universe already know. We are provided with the regular to cluster crossfade version that gives us the possibility of freely crossfading between the regular and the cluster's version of each articulation, opening an incredibly wide range of possibilities and nuances. Thank you. Okay, let's move to the Woodwinds FX High, this time consisting of 10 players, as you can see on the screen. The focus of this patch is on performant runs and arpeggios for super realistic woodwinds riding on the fly. Plain runs are 1 octave runs on every major scale, starting when you press the key, while perform octave gives you the possibility of staying on a note and then starting the run as soon as you press the octave above. And if you need it, you can also stay on the arriving note of the run. With a little practice, you can very effectively connect more octaves. And as a reminder, of course, the speed of the runs is adjustable with the built-in time stretching. You will find a cut and ringing variant, once again with 2 different release options, so you can choose between a strong and quite fast stop when you release the key, sometimes needed when you connect different articulations, and a proper long release note at the end of each run. You also find octave runs, where runs are divided into modes and specific scales such as chromatic and whole tone. Another great category spoils you with pre-recorded arpeggios. Here you find 3 BPM starting points, so the idea is that you pick the BPM closer to your project tempo and then sync those arpeggios with the help of the built-in stretch feature. Then you just have to pick the chord variant and the direction of the arpeggio, up, down, or cross. Here you not only find the cut and ringing variants, but the ringing options now come with 2 options, lowest and highest release note. A musical example will clarify it better than words. With the ringing variants, I find it very effective and even inspiring to use arpeggios for short phrases like this. Let's have a quick look at the available mics, and this information is going to be useful for the second part of this video too. Other than the main and main center mics representing your decatree, the additional room microphones around high and high surround and the mid microphones, you also see that you have dedicated spot mics for the three bass clarinets, the two bassoons, and for the trio made of two bass and one contrabass clarinets. Okay, as mentioned in this chapter, I really wanted to include an example to show you how this library, and in particular the high and low woodwinds patches, is really suitable for a textural and sound design oriented kind of woodwinds writing. I think the main reasons for this are mainly two. First, the synchron stage is a huge space, but the reverb is very controlled, and especially closed mics are really dry, especially when compared to other similar multi-mic libraries. The second reason is that the synchron mixer comes with internal plugins that are available on every discrete channel, and that might very well save you hours of routing and setup work. As always, you find the process presets category, but I want to start something from scratch with you. So my approach in that case is to start with the driest sound possible, as that gives me more control and a good amount of sound clarity and definition before my processing chain. Starting with a reverberated sound can make things too messy too soon, in my opinion. So I keep only the spot and mid mics enabled. And I also spread them a bit more across the stereo image using power panning. Now I can rename the reverb channel to something like processing, remove the reverb plugin and put in some other plugins instead. For example, the saturator. And we can tweak several parameters in here, saturation type, saturation amount, and more. Let's create a new aux now, and I name it Space Mode. You will understand in a moment why. Here, in fact, I will insert a rotary and a widener plugin. To the left of the synchron mixer, you can activate the aux view with a display of all available aux sends per channel. Instead of sticking to a fixed value, I assign the same controller to each of them, and I thought I used Aftertouch as a source, as my master keyboard offers me that possibility. It means that the more I put pressure on the keys after I played a note, the higher the aux send amount will be. I think that is going to give me a very cool feeling of control over the sound, without the need of moving other faders. In fact, I want to keep my hands free to control CC1 for the regular to cluster crossfade and CC2 for the velocity crossfade using my breath controller. Before testing the result, since we are going towards a more textural sound, I also want to increase the attack time to guarantee me a soft entering of each note. Okay, let's test the result. I think we can push the saturation a bit more. And I think we can also add a delay. That's a pretty cool sci-fi sound, starting from a single patch and articulation. And we can obviously take that sound wherever we want in our DAW with our favorite plugins. Okay, now let's think about some interesting additional modulation for the Woodwinds FX High as well. I have a crazy idea about the arpeggios that I think will turn out pretty cool. The principle is the same. We're taking advantage of the pristine, pretty dry orchestral performance and throw in several plugins to get an evolving, complex, and interesting result. Minor arpeggios are probably the best choice for the sort of atmosphere I am aiming for. I choose the same mics as before, but this time I will just set the aux send to the maximum for each channel. On the reverb channel, this time I will add a plate reverb, a delay, and finally a widener. Actually, I just had another idea, and I want to see if it makes sense to automate the power pan as well. Well, it seems it is, so guess what? This time I will control that one with the aftertouch. This is working great. Here we go. I really hope you enjoyed the third chapter of my Synchron Woodwinds walkthroughs, and remember, we will actually have a fourth chapter as soon as the additional second soloists for the flute, oboe, clarinet, and bassoon will be released with a free update in 2022. So do not forget to subscribe to this channel and activate the notification bell for the VSL's YouTube channel so you won't miss part 4. Thanks a lot for watching and see you soon.